agenda.
While Arizona's new immigration law has stirred a national debate, we're taking a closer look at some of the immigration policies here in New Mexico.
Action 7 News reporter Will Carr joins us now with a look at one of our sanctuary cities.
Doug and Shelley, it's a place where law enforcement doesn't ask for documentation and does not arrest people for being in the country illegally. It's called a sanctuary city. It's exactly what we have in Santa Fe.
Santa Fe is known for having enacted policies that build trust between the immigrant community, the Latino community, and the police department, as opposed to dividing. And that has a positive effect on public safety for everyone.
That effect is one reason why Marcela Diaz decided to work for the immigrant rights organization Somos Un Pueblo Unido. But it's also a reason why Santa Fe has been classified as a sanctuary city, a safe haven for illegal immigrants.
Well, immigrants are a part of our community. Most immigrants live in mixed families because of these broken immigration laws. Some of us have not had the ability to be able to regularize our status.
A 1999 Santa Fe City ordinance says that city resources cannot be used to identify illegal immigrants. So basically that took looking at IDs and documents off the table. Now that is on the opposite end of the spectrum of the law that just passed in Arizona, which basically gives officers the right to look for IDs and documents if they have a reasonable suspicion that someone is illegal.
Really, our state legislature, I think, have taken a much more common sense approach to immigration.
And Diaz says whether you like it or not, immigrants are a part of our community in trying to deal with the broken immigration laws.
But that doesn't mean that our families aren't contributing to our economy, to our culture, and to the fabric of our community.
But not everyone in New Mexico is happy about sanctuary cities or any type of help for illegal immigrants. On our You Local page, Lorraine B. says, I'm tired of all these liberals crying about racial profiling. Illegals should not receive the benefits from our country. Then Schlimbacher says, you are illegal and the rights you have under the law are to be either arrested and jailed or just deported at the discretion of the law. If you want the rights of an American, then become an American. So, Doug, certainly some passionate views on both sides of this controversial topic.
Sure are. And you can add your voice by going to KOAT.com and clicking on the You Local box in the middle of our homepage.